Hello. Yeah, so hello one and all, and a very good evening to all those who have joined me from India. I am Monish Singh Jadon, founder and CEO of ZNetLive. All of us gathered today shall agree with me that time is the most important asset for all of us. And it's the efficient time management that defines the personality of any winner. All of us have 24 hours of the day and to juggle between our personal and professional life. And it is actually the time saved that accounts for the time we earn for ourselves. Hence, this time that all of you have managed to take out from your busy schedule to listen to my outlook on time management and effective team management should actually help you to earn and learn something today. So without wasting much of your time, let me start with this session for today. I will be keeping it as short as possible so that we can have more time for open house and Q&A session post this. So here is the today's agenda. Who I am, my experience and journey so far. About my business, how do I manage my team, and then demo of my productivity tools, and then Q&A sessions. So who I am? So it's me. Sorry, that's it. Hold on. Mostly solo traveler, and I'm nature loving and love exploring new places when I go somewhere for business or personal traveling. I'm fond for me time. I actually always find some time for myself to go for with me. And my family is my strength. So you can see my family pic here and my friends, my travel diary has experienced all collected from all over the globe. So you can see my picture from left to Udaipur to Jaipur and then New Orleans or Washington DC. So I mostly travel across the world. So it's me. So I want to just throw one poll. How frequently do you travel? I want to launch a poll, just hold on. So this poll. So I want to encourage you to give some votes on the poll. So I want to show this result on the screen after this poll. So I'm closing this poll now. Just 20 seconds, I will close this poll. So I want to share the poll result. This is the poll result we have. So mostly we travel at least once in a month. So we all travel. Some people travel once in a month and thrice a month and more than 1 week also. So this is the result now. So now let's move forward. And let's go ahead further. So now this is my personal journey so far, personal and professional journey so far. So I have very small 18 years of industry experience. It's very, very small for me. And work towards launching new solutions and products that are based on input taken from actual users. So we always go to some events and we meet the people, our partners, and accordingly we design our product. And so our complete product range is focused after the customer or partner feedbacks. And I mostly travel across the globe for just feedback for my product, my services. And I always believe in work anywhere. So you can work from anywhere and always be connected with your team. And I research almost 12 to 6 hours in a day. So this is my research time. So I always ready to learn new things from anyone, anywhere. And right now I'm managing 100 plus team size. And it's spread across the world. It's me, basically. And I always believe in teamwork and effective team collaboration. So about my company right now. So about ZNetLive, it's just a small introduction. We are founded in 2001 and 100 plus team size, data centers, 30 plus regions. So we work very, very closely with our partners like Entity, Microsoft, and AWS. So combined data center region is 34 plus. We have 10 offices globally across the world and 15 plus competencies we have, including Microsoft, AWS. We are NASCOM member and we are gold competency as we also awarded by Deloitte in 2010 and 11. This is brief about the company and these are the competencies we have right now. So Facebook, Google, and our services and is rated by 15,200 actual users by 5-star. So this is the credibility we have right now. And these are the offices we have across the country. Two are our virtual offices and rest are the physical offices. And this is our customer base right now. So we have customer base from all across the verticals, starting from software, telecom, FMCG, chemicals, healthcare, automobiles, banking, tours and travels, real estates. So we have customer base from majorly all the verticals right now. So we mostly focus on cloud management services, starting from cloud assessment, whether you should go on on cloud or not, and roadmap guidance, workload ready, your staff system, process and tools for the across the world, across the cloud. Then cloud migration and deployment. So we are we work very closely with Microsoft and AWS for cloud migration and deployment services. And then cloud infrastructure operations management. And we help companies to migrate their infrastructure on cloud with management and operation management. And we, after migration, we do the monitoring, cost optimization, cost monitoring, service monitoring, and all the service, all the monitoring services we do. And apart from that, we work very, very closely on cloud security part, and then cost optimization. So this is our cloud management portfolio for providing the services on cloud. So whether it's Office 365 or Google Apps or Amazon Web Services or Microsoft Azure or IBM Cloud, so we work very, very closely with these guys to for cloud adoption. So we can, so either you choose AWS or Azure or whatever cloud you choose, we help you to migrate your workload on the cloud. So how do I manage my team? So I, as I said, I frequently, I'm traveling frequently, very, very frequently across the world. So you can see the picture from Central Park, New York, Mumbai, Nainital, Singapore. And for them, for managing my team, I mostly use Office 365 and some tools of G Suite. So I'm facing some problem in the demo. So I have sent a YouTube link for you guys for to see the demo. So you can see the demos yourself at your computer also. So I'm not playing the demo in the webinar. Sorry, I can't play the video on my webinar. So I have already sent the video on chat box, so you can see yourself. And we can move forward and I'll share my screen again. And I will throw another poll. So you can see the poll. What's the challenges for or obstacles to in adopting the productivity tools like Office 365 or G Suite? So I'm waiting for poll. Very interesting result is coming up with the poll. So I'm closing the poll in next 10 seconds. So this is the result. So mostly 50% attendees voted that they have pricing concerns. So I want to tell you that Microsoft and Google both have reduced the price significantly. So you can avail these services starting from only 125 rupees, either from Google or Microsoft. So pricing, I don't think it's a concern for us, all of us as of now. And lack of awareness, obviously, so that's why we have just created a video. I have sent on your chat box, so you can see the video. What is the features of Office 365 recently launched by Microsoft? So you can see the video. And pricing, obviously, it's not a concern as of now because it's on very, very reasonable price. So I don't think it's a concern as of now.
Munish, we also have the slides of this video. If you would want to have the audience go through, I'll just share my screen and you can share your thoughts and views on the slides that we have of the video. Will this work, Munish?
Yes, please.
Okay, Munish. So Munish, is my screen visible to you also?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. So Munish, I'll be moderating the slides for you. You can keep on discussing the points that you have for each of the slide and let me know when I need to change the slides. I'll do that. Please continue now.
All right. So these are the features of Office 365. So you can see on my screen, business class mail, office applications, file storage, and calendar management, collaborations, video conferencing, audio conferencing, all the features are available on this Office 365. Yeah, can you change the slide, please? And these are the features in Office 365 as of now. So these features I have already mentioned that. So you can change the slide, no problem. Yeah, so these are the typical challenge of any SMB or enterprises, that downtime is the major challenge. So that's why this Office 365 provide, or Google Apps, both are providing 99.9% plus uptime availability on their infrastructure, whether it's a Microsoft or Google, both are providing it. And another challenge is limited mailbox size and lack of mail sync and across the devices. With Office 365, you will get Microsoft Exchange email with 50 GB of storage. I'd
like to add that the sync problem, the sync issue that Munish is talking about, can be very well resolved with Office 365. As you can see that the mails on my laptop screen are well synced with the mails on my mobile screen. The mails that I flag when I go home in my mobile, the same mails are flagged in my laptop too. So I guess, Munish, this is what we had to tell the audiences, that the sync issue that is very much prevalent and people face it is highly resolved with Office 365.
Yes, Barka, you can continue. You can explain the other features also. No issues. Hello, Barka.
Yes, Munish, I have taken the control. I'll be browsing through the slides now.
Yeah. So you can explain the other features also. No issues.
Okay, Munish. So we saw that with Office 365, the issue of mail sync is highly resolved, as in the mails that you access on your mobile are well synced with the other devices also. So another challenge that businesses face is the challenge of loss of critical business data. The data that a business has is highly for them, for the businesses, the data that they have, and they cannot actually think about losing it at any hour of the day. So with Office 365, you get a 1000 GB cloud storage, that is 1 terabyte of cloud storage. So there is no issue at all as far as storing your data is considered. And since this storage is done on cloud, the loss of any mishap, the loss of data due to any mishap is something which any business can be assured of, any business owner can be assured of. And as you can see on my screen now, this OneDrive feature that Office 365 gives to its users with 1000 GB of data storage, you can store as much of data you want, and we rest assured of its security because eventually it is going to be stored on cloud. Moreover, the data that you share also on OneDrive is secure. You can safely share it amongst the people who are using Office 365. We ourselves are using SharePoint, this spectacular feature of Office 365. This feature allows us to access the documents, the access of these documents that we have. And the icing on the cake is that we can access and work on these documents online as well as offline. If you can see on my screen, I have been given access to the departments, to some of the departments of my organization, and I can make changes, edit in those files and datas wherever I want, whenever I want, irrespective of the fact whether I'm connected with internet or not. So this is the online view of SharePoint, and this is the offline view of the SharePoint. So whatever I edit in the offline mode automatically gets synced in the morning when I come and I have to work. It is already synced there and I don't have to be, again connected. So when I open the offline version of SharePoint, the things that I did last night without the internet connection get synced there. So this is another spectacular feature of Office 365 that in addition to the storage of 1000 GB data that it gives you, the safe storage on cloud that it gives you, it also allows you to access huge amount of data online as well as offline, and that too very well synced. Okay, so as Munish already spoke about his personality, his travel plans and his travel schedules that he has during the tough and busy life schedule that he has. So it is a must for every person who is, whether a person is an employee or a business owner, to be connected with his or her team anytime and every time. Because lack of collaboration and communication with clients is a major reason for lack of productivity of any business. So if we want our business to be productive, if we want our teams to be productive, we need to ensure that they are, in communication, in sync, and highly collaborated. So there is no communication gap amongst the people in the organization, also with the clients. So with Office 365, there is a feature called Skype for Business, which allows you to do online video conferencing. Also, there is a feature called Microsoft Teams, wherein people in a particular team can create their own team group and share the comments, share the progress of the work with each other without wasting time in drafting emails and giving calls to each other. Many of our people in the organization are working from remote places, and Munish already showed that we have virtual offices in Singapore and other locations in India. So there is no point traveling to different places in India or to other places of the world. Rather, they also don't come to our headquarters. We sit in our offices, they sit in their remote places, and we keep connected. We keep exchanging our views and the work that we do. So at the end, I would like to say that this spectacular feature that Office 365, the productivity suit that is, it has actually diminished the boundaries that are there between different zones of the nation and the world overall. So as you can see, my colleague who sits in another part of the country and I sit here in the headquarters, so we can give each other a call and discuss on any work that is going on, and we don't have to waste much of our time in waiting for the reverse of the emails or waiting for the other person to open the email, check, and then revert back. We immediately give a call, we discuss on the work, and we get it done. So this was all about the features that I'm sure most of you must be knowing. And if it is an eye-opener for some of you, it would be a privilege for us. And let me also talk about some unexplored features that Office 365 has. Actually, it's a bucket of a lot of features. Most of them are unexplored yet. So let me talk about one by one. Delve is a spectacular feature of Office 365, wherein you can work from wherever you want. You can explore, you can extract the data from your OneDrive, you can extract the data from your SharePoint, you can put in rules that you want that other people cannot access it, you can use it, and you can work on the documents that are stored either in SharePoint or that are stored in your OneDrive, with the limit that everybody cannot work on it. Only those who have the access can do. Planner. So Munish and many people, including me, like, we work on planners. We don't have to waste time sitting in front of each other and discussing on the task, that what is the current status of the task, and giving updates in personal meetings. Rather, we have a planner, Microsoft Office 365 planners app installed on our mobiles, and this planner app actually helps us in knowing the status of the task. We don't have to report to each other, we don't have to sit in front of each other. We just update the task in the app, and the person who has delegated the task gets to know the latest update about that task, whether it has been started, whether it is in progress, or whether it is completed. Entire thing is managed on our mobiles via this app. The beauty of this app is it saves the time of in-person meetings. That is a big reason of time wastage in organizations and for people. Tasks. It is also the same thing that we don't have to worry, we don't have to worry about our task. We just need to click on the task of the Outlook that Microsoft Office 365 provides, and we'll get a complete array of the task that we flagged, so that we don't have to go into each of the mails and then find out what are the tasks that are supposed to be done, or what are the pending pendencies that we have on ourselves. Sway. It is a very beautiful feature. People in our organization have stopped being dependent on the designers. Everybody is a designer in ZNetLive, whether it is a newsletter, whether it is a PDF that has to be created, a collateral that has to be created. Everybody can create collaterals, very beautiful newsletters on their own with this beautiful feature of Office 365, which is Sway. Visual. This is, I guess, the most unexplored feature, wherein people actually do not know the importance of this app. It helps the users of Office 365 to know about the analytics that they are working on, the analytics of the data that they are working on, the analytics of the strategies that they are working on. So Visio gives you a complete conclusion, a complete analytic view of the strategies and the data that any business is using. Yammer is like your organization's Facebook. So you can post the latest updates on Yammer. You can ask your people, you can ask your team members to comment on your updates, to give you suggestions and feedback on the things that you post in Yammer instantly, without wasting. Again, I'm saying, most important thing is that we waste times in writing emails and waiting for people to revert on the emails, give feedback, give their opinion. Rather than that, Office 365's Yammer gives us this beautiful feature that we can post any update on Yammer and wait for people, without waiting for people to read, go through their emails. Instantly we get the feedback, instantly we get the updates that we actually expect from our teams. So this is all about the explored and unexplored features of Office 365. Munish, would you want to continue from here?
Yes, Barkha. So after that, I think we should start the Q&A session. If anyone has any question, they can ask. Sure. And I'm happy to answer those questions.
Thank you, Munish. So we have a good number of people who are attending our webinar. So we are open for the open house. The QA session is open now. So we would be happy to answer the questions that any of you have.
You can type the question on the message box also. And if you would like to speak, then let us know. We can unmute you. Or you can send a mail on my email ID. My email ID, you can note down my email ID. My email ID is munesh@znetlive.com, munesh@znetlive.com, and you can send the mail directly to me for any questions. So Barkha, I think no questions as of now, so they can send the mail to me directly if they have any questions. So we can yes, one question is coming. Nitin this side, could you please tell me that we can import old mail record into Office 365? Currently we have JuSuite. This is also purchased from your side. Okay, yes. So Nitin, we can our support team can migrate your data from G Suite to Office 365. You can reach out to our account manager for that. From Sushil, the question is, can we have a recording? Yes, so we are recording the session and we will send you after this webinar. Thank you Munish for answering the queries.
Yes, Nitin, we'll be surely sending you the recordings. Yes, Sushil, as Munish said, we'll be sharing the recordings as soon as the webinar is over. Munish, I guess the queries have been handled and rest they can directly be raised to you as you have already spoken about. So let us end the webinar here. And to conclude, I would like to take this opportunity to thank each one of you who took out some time to know how CEO of ZNetLive manages his team and his time. Yes, Munish.
And Barkha, you can also share your email ID so that they can also reach out to you directly.
Yes, my email ID is barkha@znetlive.com. So in case you want to reach out to me, you can drop those queries in my inbox. I'll be happy to assist you. Thank you, everyone. So we are ending this webinar here. It was a pleasure to have you all here and discuss on this time management and time saving productivity tool with you, and the personal time management tips and tricks by Munish Yadav, CEO and founder of ZNetLive. Thank you all. So we are ending this webinar here. Thank you, everyone, and have a great evening ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you so much.